Hello everyone and welcome to the first episode of Cloud Solutions with Cosmo. Today we are excited to create a REST API using Serverless Framework, AWS Lambda function in Python and DynamoDB. Hope you guys like this tutorial and leave your feedback in the comment section below. So what is Serverless Framework? Serverless Framework is a free and open source web framework developed for building application on AWS Lambda. And AWS Lambda is a serverless computing platform provided by Amazon as a part of Amazon Web Services. AWS Lambda is an event-driven serverless computing platform that runs code in response to event, and we are using DynamoDB, which is a non-SQL database provided by the Amazon. So the first thing you need is an AWS account and PyCharm. Okay, now let's create a project and name it as learning. The project is successfully created. Now let's install serverless. To install serverless, you have to install Node.js 2. And here comes another error. This means that scripts are disabled in this system. Just open up the PowerShell and paste this command. And boom guys, it's installing serverless. After that, when you type in serverless, it will give you list of options. So we select AWS Python and name our project. As you see, it's downloading its template. As I already mentioned in the start of this video that you need an AWS account and AWS credentials. So we create AWS access keys. Just click on the link and it will navigate to the AWS console where you can create your user and its access keys. Enter the information and click next. Uncheck this box. And now choose a user group. If you haven't already created, then create a group and select it. After you have created a user, navigate to security credentials and create access key. Here you need to select command line interface. Copy paste access key ID and secret key and then deploy it. So that is the basic serverless template. You can change your AWS region details by typing in AWS configure in the command line. And before that, you have to install AWS CLI. We can define our custom settings such as stage for dev environment. And then we have to provide these state and region into provider section too. So now the major problem everyone faces is that they don't know how to import a layer. To create a layer, we have to install a plugin. We are going to install serverless Python requirement plugin. and serverless IAM role per function. I will explain this plugin later on. And these two plugins might come in handy later on. So the package defines which files the layer is going to include. It will exclude the node modules and every other file and just going to include common from the source folder and the pattern we are going to define in every function. And to create a REST API, define events and HTTP API. Then define the path and the method for that function. And now let's create a DynamoDB table. So instead of going into console and create a DynamoDB, serverless provides a template in the resource section where you can define a name for table, its attributes and key schema, and GSI, Global Secondary Index. In the end of this section, write the table name and then write the table name and then provide it in the custom setting. Provide the stage name in the custom setting. We have to install these plugins as well. npm I serverless Python requirement and npm I serverless IAM role permission. Role and npm I serverless IAM role per function. IAM npm I serverless IAM role per function. When we are going to deploy our serverless, it is going to package all the files and install all the requirements. And we have to provide files in the requirement.txt file. This error means we have to turn our Python requirement layers equal to true. And it is successfully deployed in our AWS serverless. As you see, we have layers and API gateway as well, linked with the Lambda function. To explain GSI in DynamoDB, I have just created a GSI named type phone number index. And here it is how we are going to define our role statement. This role permission is going to be specifically just for this function only. We are defining a table with its index and specific actions. So when we deploy this, it is showing an error that attribute definition is missing an attribute. Let's define these two and deploy again. and here is DynamoDB, and we have successfully created its index. Here is another important thing, that whenever you want a serverless to provide information for the Lambda function, you can just pass this in environment like AWS service, region and state, so that Lambda function can access these. To put an item in DynamoDB, we are using Boto 3 and some of Boto 3 core exceptions. Here we are going to create an event and save it. Then we have to test this function. As the function name is hello, and here we are using os.environment. We have to import this, and we have successfully inserted one record in our DynamoDB. Thank you so much for watching.